1998. So, I'm back for more Back to the Future, the game. Been having audio issues lately. Buzzing and echoing sounds, but not much I can do about that, really. Get headphones and stuff, and longer headphones for TV and blah, blah, blah. You know how it is. Anyways, on with the game. Yes. I'm sure. Tuesday, August 25th, 1931. Alright. Let's play. Change the music some more. Let's play a sad song.
Come to me, my melancholy baby. Cuddle up and don't be blue.
He's sad.
All your fears are foolish, fancy.
Let's talk to him.
You know, dear, Danny.
You.
So about those troubles.
It all started on June 14th. I was chasing down one of Tannen's boys when this car, straight out of Buck Rogers, popped up out of nowhere and ran my car off the road.
No.
Then later, I lost track of a witness. A poor schlub hasn't been heard from since.
That wasn't your fault.
And then, to top it off, I somehow managed to lose custody of an 80-year-old arsonist. Well, not one, but two of those godforsaken space cars showed up and whisked him away.
That's unbelievable.
That's what the chief said. Demoted me on the spot. My family sent me to a psychiatrist because they thought I was seeing things. And worst of all, my gal Betty left me. Because she thinks I'm a bad provider and a head case.
Betty? As in Jennifer's grandma, Betty?
What?
Listen, Danny, it's really important that you get back together with Betty.
Oh, that ship sailed. The heck with her. I got a little secret that'll set me up with women twice as classy as Betty'll ever be.
You got a secret? What is it?
I don't think I should tell you. When I'm sad like this, I don't think straight. But listen.
Yes?
I like you. You're my new best friend.
Excellent.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
Someone's got a secret. Secret song. Cause yep. Now let's see what he says. Because secret songs make people want to tell you their secrets.
Danny.
You.
So about that secret.
Oh, yeah. My secret. Well, you're my pal, so I can tell you. But don't let it get out. I've been working for Tannen for a month now.
What?
It's true.
What?
All I gotta do is look the other way while evidence is getting destroyed or a truck full of gin is coming across the county line. And Tannen makes sure an extra bunch of bills makes their way into my pay envelope. Great deal, huh?
Yeah, if you're a rat.
What's the problem? People need to drink, right? As long as no one's getting hurt, why shouldn't Daniel J. Parker make a few bucks on the action?
What about Artie McFly? Hasn't he been missing for 2 months?
That's true, and all signs point to a tannin job. Oh god, I've made a horrible mistake! I thought if I could get my hands on some money, that Betty'd take me back! But when she finds out what I've done, she'll never even talk to me again. What have I done?
No.
Come on, Danny, pull yourself together. It's not so bad.
Not so bad? I'm a corrupt cop who's lost his only chance at true love. How's that not so bad?
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God.
At. Edna's lyrics. It's time to switch it up.
Hey, Trixie, look over there!
Why?
Didn't you see it?
No.
Ah, never mind.
Time for music.
You should care. You should care what people think of you.
She's right. I can turn my life around.
Sure you can.
You know what? I used to be a good cop. And yeah, I've had a few bad breaks. Possibly even a psychotic one that caused me to imagine a disappearing space car. But I'm a good man.
Yeah.
And all I need to do to win Betty back is be the same good man I always was. Let the chips fall where they may.
All right. So, now what?
Now I wait. Wait for the moment to take down Kid Tannen, restore my good name, and win back the heart of Betty Lipinski.
Hold that thought. I bet that moment is just around the corner.
At. Time to find Artie. walking. What?
Emmett.
No time for chit-chat. I've got a rocket car to recover.
Emmett! You get down from there before you hurt yourself!
Hurt myself? You're far too cautious, Miss Strickland.
Oh. Can't walk in the street. Because I'm a law-abiding citizen. But time to go to the flop house.
Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
I saw him.
Who?
My grandpa, on his streetcar for just a second. Doc, we gotta find him.
Why?
Trixie thinks she's got something that could put Kid away, but Artie's the only one who can tell her for sure. I guess he's kind of her tutor or something.
Ah, so that's the connection. When your grandfather disappeared from Hill Valley for 2 months, the bond between him and Miss Trotter was severed, eventually leading to a timeline in which Trixie lost the nerve to betray Tannen.
Yeah?
We've got to find your grandfather.
Good news, Doc. Parker's ready to arrest Tannen, and it looks like I didn't go stag to the prom.
Wonderful. What about Miss Trotter?
I'm still working on her. Should we be worried about your younger self and Enda Strickland?
That is a peculiar wrinkle in the space-time continuum, but I'm sure nothing will come of it. I can't possibly imagine myself becoming attached to a woman like that.
Any sign of Artie?
Haven't spotted him yet.
Why are Tannens always such jerks, anyway?
It's hard to say. Rogue Neanderthal genes in their DNA, perhaps.
Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Okay. Ooh. Is there anything over here on the... Oh, there he is.
Hey, boy, how you doing? Good dog.
Hey, doggy. Want to smell something again?
Hey, boy, take a whiff of this. Gotta love that nose.
I've been laying low, officer, but I've got to go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But...
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good.
Run! To the flop house, cause...
Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Just stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're I chucked sure you into be this because here? I'm the
Perfectly
best
safe.
There is.
We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Hey.
What?
I'll have a drink.
What's your poison?
Peps. On second thought, forget it.
Suit yourself.
Who are you working on now?
Boris Karloff. What do you think?
Not bad. Who are you working on now?
Boris Karloff. What do you think?
Not bad. What's it like working for Tannen?
You looking for a job?
No.
Then stop being so nosy.
So, getting back to Trixie.
She sings. She's the kid's squeeze. What more do you need to know?
Talk to you later.
Hey, look, a paying customer.
See.
I don't know about world famous, but she's not a bad entertainer. Trixie?
Yeah?
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
to... Cover for me, Q-Ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for
sure fighting. I was.
Why, you?
I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate.
All right, fella. I think you're done for the night. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you. What do you know about this?
Nothing. I...
Ah!
Trixie?
Breaks over, Q-Ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that? Trixie?
Yeah?
What happened in the alley with Arthur?
I don't want to talk about it.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Alright, let's see.
I don't need another caricature of my dad. Pretty bunch. Not a pretty bunch.
Where is that? Did I get that character guy mess up? Oh god.
Not sure what that.
Great.
Not sure what that. Sorry, lady. I didn't mean to get your boyfriend kicked out of the club.
Oh, water under the bridge. You want to keep his seat warm?
Thanks anyway. Trixie?
Yeah?
Turning on me.
Hey, it looks like they've put a new picture on the Wall of Fame.
Oh, jeez, kid. Who'd you bump off this time? Who's that supposed to be? Mickey Rooney?
I don't think so. Hey, your
great
song seemed to have a big effect on Officer Parker over there.
I am humbled and gratified that my musical gifts have fallen upon such receptive ears.
What about your insurance policy?
There ain't no insurance policy. After tonight, I'm tossing it in the furnace and burning it up.
Come on, Trixie, can't you tell me what happened out there? Then at least give me the evidence you got on Kid.
No,
I made a deal with myself. As soon as tonight's set is over, the evidence goes up in smoke.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Good boy.
Hey, what? Do you know what happened to Trixie out there? She seems pretty freaked out.
You talk weird, you know that? But no, I don't know nothing about Trixie's emotional state. Kid doesn't pay me nearly enough to pour drinks and babysit his crazy girlfriends.
Talk to you later.
Hey, look, a paying customer.
Again. And there's the blood.
Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head, which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then...
What?
Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live! Seriously, down on her knees, crying and begging for McFly's life. So,
funny.
What did you do? What could I do? I fired two shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
Always.
I guess that's Grandpa's nose blood.
Let's see if I can get a...
Welcome back, sir. Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
Voila!
Nice job.
Now go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
Now, this should work.
Sorry about this, Dad.
You just made the list.
You in?
Nope. Still can't get this trophy.
Seven.
Alright. Let's get Trixie in. Tricks are for kids.
Trixie?
Yeah?
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
I think something bad might have happened to him.
What? You mean Kid went back on his promise?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh no! Oh, poor Artie! Poor sweet little Artie!
I know.
That rattlesnake kid! He can't get away with this!
You gonna turn over the evidence you got against him?
Am I ever? Just watch me! Wait a minute. What evidence do you have that kid bumped Artie off?
It's just a hunch.
Keep your hunches for the racetrack. It ain't nice to get a girl all worked up over unsubstantiated rumors.
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of kids' books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper!
Womander.
What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime...
All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy? You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Out. Da, da, da. Uh-oh.
Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
Yes.
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up in the next, company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually.
Uh-oh.
Parker must have confiscated this hooch from the speakeasy. Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out.
Ooh,
it's
flask.
Empty. Figures.
Hey, Einstein. Time to go smell it again.
Hey, Einie, get your nose over here.
This way.
All right.
Let's do this.
I don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie. Okay, I'll check it out.
A
button.
Push the button.
Empty, so what's the point?
Okay, don't push the button with the bottle, idiot. Push the button.
All right, Doc, here I come.
Rocket, what are you doing here?
Never mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist. Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker? Tannen, you're under arrest. Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there! Watch out!
Why does everybody fall for that?
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
Oh boy. Here we go.
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
Tannens never make things easy. Tannen, make like a tree and die, rat! No one messes with Kid Tannen!
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Yeah, with me dancing on your grave.
Bowling for tens.
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting?
All right. So you distract them.
I could do this all night, Parker.
Hey, kid.
Lead, phony. Hey, moron. Moron, this.
Go,
Tannen! Make like a tree and die, rat! Hey!
Atta girl.
Hey, kid! Lead, phony! So...
I'm afraid I'm finding it difficult to concentrate with all the bullets flying around my head, Mr. Crockett.
Right!
Right. It's time to light the fire.
No one messes with Kid Tannen. Hey, kid. That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Boom.
Oh, crap.
Fire.
Hey, he's getting away!
Oh no.
Hmm. Ew.
Yes. No. There. Good as new.
Oh, look,
Tannen.
The judge's son. All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Doc.
Marty.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Great Scott!
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I?
You! Damn it!
Alright.
The cause of all of this, ain't you?
Uh-oh. It's all about timing now.
I mean, Sonny Crockett?
Yeah, well, what kind of gangster's named Irving?
Hey!
Yes! Doc, got it. That was fast.
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
All yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc.
Alright. Happy ending.
DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
I'm absolutely sure that everything's back to normal.
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Do you feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Uh-oh.
Edna, they're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd.
Gotta
get back in. Stop the car. This could be disastrous.
Stop. Uh-oh. Something bad happened.
Where'd you go, Doc?
We've got everything under control.
Doc?
It's a big Doc. To be continued in part 6 of the movie. The next episode.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
0 demerits until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?
Citizen Brown. It looks like we screwed with the present again, or technically the past, since 1986. But we screwed with Marty's present again. As the credits are rolling, I guess that's all for now, again. So, join us next time for next part of the movie, or game, and part 4. The Back to the Future, the game. Enjoy the randomness, and I'll see you next time.